Today is very, very special day. Who knows what is special today?
Aha!
Who knows what is special today?
I guess one of them figured it out easily.
Yes, it's happy birthday to India! This is Arav. Hi, I'm Preeti. And tonight is very special. We will talk about the story of India, the story of independence of India.
I forgot to introduce my name and my mother's. I'm such a scatterbrain.
All right, guys. So let's see which of the friends are here. If you are new here, say hello to us in the comment section. Hi, Adya.
Happy India Independence Day.
Hi, Kashvi.
Happy Independence Day.
It's about India's independence. Do you know anything about India's independence? We will learn today. Okay. Hi, Neera. We missed you yesterday. Where were you, buddy? We missed you a ton yesterday, you know. Right, Arav?
Yeah, I think Neera was in yesterday's story.
No, Neera wasn't there yesterday and we missed him a lot. And I'm just adjusting my bindi so that it's in the center. Now it looks good. Okay.
Wait, where's the cake?
Hi, Anirudh. Happy Independence Day. We have a surprise for you today at the end of the story. Are you all excited? It's not really a story today. It's more about learning about India's independence journey. Okay? Hi, Arav.
Happy Independence Day.
Happy Independence Day. What are the colors of Indian flag?
Happy Indian Independence Day.
Do you know what are the colors of Indian flag?
May I tell the surprise?
Not now, Arav. Okay. It's a surprise. We have to share the surprise with you at the end of the story. Meanwhile, there is a quiz for you before we start the story. What are the colors in an Indian flag? Do you know the colors in an Indian flag?
Yes, I do.
Giving you a hint, I am wearing some of them, okay? Look at my bindi, look at my dupatta, and look at my kurti, okay? So I'm wearing some of the colors and even my bangles.
I know.
I'm wearing some of the colors of the Indian flag. Yes. You can whisper in my ears. I also want to know from the friends if they know the colors of Indian flag.
Green, white. Is that wrong?
No, Arav gave me three colors. There are actually four colors, okay? Saffron, that's right. White, that's right. And green, that's also right. Awesome, Neera.
What's saffron?
And there is a chakra of blue color. Later we will meet the Indian flag.
I already mentioned blue.
You mentioned blue, you mentioned green, you mentioned white, but you didn't mention saffron. Saffron is like orange, okay? You see the color in that picture over there, which says, when and why do we celebrate Independence Day? Mm-hmm. That was very good, Neera. Now, do you know when do we celebrate India's Independence Day? Which date is it? It's again very easy. It's today's date. I hope you know today's date. Do you?
8th August.
Arav, when was your birthday?
13th August.
No.
12th August.
Arav doesn't know today's 14th
date. 14th August.
No.
15th August.
Yes. After so many guesses, it's correct. So 15th August is the Indian Independence Day. Awesome. Anirudh, awesome. All right. Let's start, guys. Are we ready? Ready, Arav?
Yeah.
All right. Here we go. Oops. What? Yes.
Remember the day, Adi?
When and why do we celebrate Independence Day? You know, guys, India was colonized for over 200 years.
Huh?
A lot of Britishers came and they made colonies in India. Okay?
What does that mean?
Later you will understand. Okay?
Yeah.
And people of India, they demanded complete independence from the foreigners, from the Britishers. Yeah. This happened many, many years ago. Yeah. The proposed date for Indian independence was 26 January 1930. But they did not get independence on the 26th of January. When did they get independence? On the 15th of
August. I have to ask something.
Yes.
What is colonized?
Colonized means a lot of people came and made like small colonies. Like we live in a colony, isn't it?
What is colony?
You can say our colony is Bayshore. Like that. Small parts. Oh. Small areas in a country. Okay?
Yeah. Okay.
If you have any questions, you also write it down in the comment section. So there were many, many colonies for more than 200 years. Yeah. This is the Indian flag. Then on July 18, 1947, a law was passed stating that India would become an independent country on the 15th of August. So when did they decide? When did they pass the law? On July 1947. And 1 month later, on August 15th, India got its independence. And it is celebrated as Independence Day in India. Okay, like today. Later we will find out how do we celebrate Independence Day, yeah? So, we also do a lot of like flag hoisting. You see the flag over there? Why do we celebrate Independence Day? Do you know?
Because of the sacrifice of the people who fought all the Britishers. How many kills they got. You showed me one movie about it, remember?
Yeah, right, exactly. Many of our freedom fighters, our leaders, they lost their lives fighting for the freedom of India. So, we celebrate today, Independence Day, in the memory, in the remembrance of the sacrifices which the leaders made. Otherwise, Arab, did you see Mama, Papa going for any war or fighting for any freedom?
No.
Did you all see your mom or dad fighting for any freedom? Or your grandparents? Did Dadu fight for freedom?
No.
Then how would you know if we don't tell you, right? Yeah?
Yeah.
If we don't celebrate Independence Day and if we don't share with you about the sacrifices of the leaders, you would never know, right?
Yeah.
You would think that it was always like this. We were always free. But no, a lot of people, they even sacrificed their lives so that we could get freedom. What is freedom?
Like we could get free from them.
We could get free from them. We can live however we want. Yeah?
Yeah.
We can do whatever work we want. We can go to whichever school we want.
India was also clever, right?
India was clever.
By it fought, but after that, they wanted no king. So, they just created some robotic machine or something.
Robotic machine?
And then that also had all the laws, right?
I'm not sure about that, okay? So, now you know why we celebrate Independence Day?
Yeah.
And you know when we celebrate Independence Day?
15 August.
Awesome. Now guys, if you know about some of the freedom fighters who fought for India's freedom, let me know in the comment section. And I'll also share some of the names with you. Arab, you can share with the friends. No need to whisper. Because there are many, many freedom fighters.
I only know one of them from the movie, It's a Girl.
What's her name?
I don't know her name.
Is it Jhansi Ki Rani? Rani Lakshmi Bai?
No, it was not a god. But
she is not a god. Rani Lakshmi Bai is not a god. She's a freedom fighter.
Well, I think so. She was a girl and she had a sword in the end and she's killing many people.
Many Britishers, you mean?
Yeah, and one guy shot her, but she never gave up. She kept on fighting and one guy shot her.
I think Arav is talking about Rani Lakshmi Bai. She was a great freedom fighter.
Yeah. In the end, she was killing all the Britishers, almost all. But then the leader of the Britishers shot a bullet and she died. Yeah. And one more was a boy who was also killing everybody and never gave up. They had to put many swords and shoot many times on them. And that's only when
Why did they do that, Arab? They never get to enjoy. They never got to enjoy the freedom. You know, those days, everybody was not allowed to travel in the same train. There were different like trains, like, you know, smaller spaces for Indians. And they were not, there were like different classes, And they were not allowed to go to the same school. They were not allowed to go to the same hospital or a same hotel, you know. They were not allowed. So why did these people give away their lives? They couldn't even enjoy the freedom. Then why did they do that? Guys, do you know why did they do that?
For sacrifices for other people.
For other people. So what do we learn from the freedom fighters?
Always sacrificing.
Even they sacrifice their lives. It's such a big sacrifice. That's why we are celebrating India's
Independence Day.
Yes. See, it's quite nice. Our friends have shared some of the names of the freedom fighters. Bhagat Singh. I'll share the story of Bhagat Singh with you. Mahatma Gandhi. Mahatma Gandhi is also known as the father of the nation. Did you know?
No.
He's the father of the nation. Gandhiji and Mahatma Gandhi, they are the name of the same person. Yeah? Okay. Shall we go ahead? Wait. Shall I tell you more fun facts about India's Independence Day?
Yeah.
Yes? Okay. So these are some picture of some of the leaders. This man here, he's Mahatma Gandhi. This is Rani Lakshmi Bai. Okay, this is Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose. Now I'll share with you the history of India's journey towards independence. You know, Arab Britishers, they came to India to do trade, okay? Like traders under East India Company. And you know what they used to trade? They used to sell spices.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, trade spices, cotton, silk, indigo, tea, like those things they used to trade in India. And who was the leader when they came to India? It was ruled by the Mughals.
Who's the Mughals?
Mughals like Jahangir Khan, I think. Let me see. Under whose rule?
Aurangzeb.
See, they came under the rule of Emperor Jahangir. So they are the Mughals. When you read the history of India, you will know. For now, you will know that they came when the Mughals were ruling India. Okay? So see, these are the Britishers, yeah? So Arab, the Mughals were also very powerful.
Mm-hmm.
And the Britishers could not start like taking different parts of India when there was Mughal rule. Okay, they couldn't. Mm-hmm. They were just doing trade with the Indians.
Yeah.
But when the Mughal Empire disintegrated, that means mm-hmm. the Mughals were ruling, mm-hmm. but when they were not ruling anymore, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
That time, the Britishers, they started conquering small parts of India.
But why weren't the Mughals ruling anymore?
They got like, you know, they were defeated.
Like
it was always like that. If one person is the king, some other person will want to be the king and they will fight like that. The kings kept on changing. Okay? So the Mughals, they also got defeated once and there was no unity. That's why unity is very important. You fight with your friends or with your people, somebody else will come and take advantage of you. That's what happened. Yeah? So always have unity. What is unity? Friendship, understanding, forgiveness. Yeah? And no like fighting. I'm not your friend. You are not my friend. Then somebody else will come and take advantage. Like in the story of, remember, the two cats and a monkey?
Yeah.
The cats were fighting about the piece of bread.
Yeah.
And who ate all the bread?
A roti.
Yeah, a roti. Monkey ate all the roti.
Yeah.
So what do we learn, guys? What do we learn about?
You always have friendship.
Friendship and unity. Yeah? Unity is strength. It's power. Okay?
Yeah.
Very good. So here we see that after the Mughals were not powerful anymore, the Britishers, they started taking small part of India. Then there was a battle of Plassey in 1757. What was that? Would you like to know about
what?
The battle of Plassey?
Yes.
Okay. So in the battle of Plassey, Arav, Britishers East India Company, they fought with the Nawab of Bengal. They both had a fight.
Why?
Because I always told you, everybody wanted power. Everybody wanted to rule. Yeah, they wanted to be the king.
So the Bengal are not Indians, right?
No, Bengalis are also Indians. Bengal is a part of India in the northeast.
Oh, but then they just wanted to be king. That's why they fought.
So Britishers could not take the whole of India at one time, right?
Yeah.
So where did they start? In Bengal.
Oh.
That was a battle of Plassey or Plassey.
Oh, because they didn't want Britishers to take over Bengal.
So Britishers and the Nawab of Bengal, the King of Bengal, they had a fight or a war. And who won? Any guesses?
Britishers.
So first they took Bengal.
And
then they started taking different parts of India. And after 100 of years, in 1857, a lot of parts in India, they started revolting. No, this is not fair. You are ruling over us. You're not giving us any rights. You're being mean to us. So they all started fighting. And who's the famous lady here?
I think so. When I was
Rani Lakshmi Bai, she also fought, yeah?
Yeah, she looks like the same poster I was talking about.
Yeah? And a lot of other leaders. Should I tell you the name?
Yeah.
See, Rani Lakshmi Bai, Nana Sahib.
It is this one, Nana Sahib?
I'm not too sure. Could be. Nana Sahib, Tatya Tope,
yeah.
Bahadur Shah Zafar, Begum Hazrat Mehal, Mangal Pandey. These are some of the leaders. There were many, many leaders. Many, many freedom fighters. But some of the more known freedom fighters in 1857, which is almost 160 years ago.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's when these people were fighting. That's why we did not see them fighting. Because your mom, dad did not fight. Your dadu also did not fight. Dadu's time, these people were fighting. The freedom fighters. Yeah. Would you remember some of the names, Arav? You can try, right?
Yeah.
Are you feeling respect for all the leaders?
Yeah.
So this, Arav, in 1857, when the Britishers fought with a lot of Indian leaders, right? That time, they stopped expanding to other territories within India. Whatever they had already occupied, they said, okay, we will just keep this. And it's very exhausting. These people now want independence. They are fighting us. So they stopped taking more parts of India. Okay? Make sense?
Yeah.
Is it a bit difficult to understand?
No, but then...
Who is this, Arav?
Uh-huh.
Who is this?
Gandhi Singh.
Mahatma Gandhi. Yeah? This man in the picture is?
Mahatma. I have a question.
Yes?
But then why have they fully stopped taking India then now?
Fully? I'll tell you. Because, Arav, we will also talk about World War II and what happened in World War II.
What happened?
They became weak. We will talk about it, okay? That's a very good question.
How did they become weak?
I'll tell you. So, this was Mahatma Gandhi, Arav, and he started a non-cooperation movement. Yeah, he told the people of India, don't give taxes to Britishers. Don't use the clothes made by Britishers. We will make our own clothes. Don't use the salt which the Britishers sell you, okay? We will make our own salt. And non-violence. He said, if somebody slaps you on one cheek, you show the other cheek. Do not fight back. Do not be violent. Like, you fight, I fight, you fight, I fight. Don't do that. Behave by non-violence. Protest by non-violence. What's that? That means you will not fight. You will not hit anybody. That's what Mahatma Gandhiji said. Okay? So, what will you do next time if mama hits you on one cheek? You show the other cheek. Okay?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's so cute.
And then I'm a teens. Okay.
So, Mahatma Gandhi, non-cooperation movement and non-violence, two things we associated with him. And because of Mahatma Gandhi's this thing, right, all the protests, non-violence, Britishers decided, okay, fine, you guys can vote. They gave the voting rights to Indian people also. So they could decide like who will rule over them. So this was a major step. Yeah?
Yeah.
Now you know everybody votes. In India also we vote. In Singapore also we vote. And we choose who our leaders will be, right?
Yeah.
That time people did not have a choice. Only Britishers decided who will be the leaders. But then in which year? 1937. They gave voting rights. Yeah?
Yeah.
Make sense?
Yeah.
Now comes the World War II. In the year 1945, which is 2 years before we got independence, you know what happened?
What?
It was a time of World War II.
Yeah.
And in World War II, there were two main powers. Axis powers and allies. Axis and allies.
Yeah, but then how?
Axis was Germany, Italy and Japan. Allies were Britain, United States, Russia, France, like that, okay?
Yeah.
So these people fought the World War II. More than, I think, 30 countries were involved in the World War II. And it lasted for, I have it here, 6 years people fought with each other. Many lives were lost, Arab. So much of blood everywhere. And when you fight a war, you need weapon, you need food, you need people, right?
Yeah.
It costs a lot of money. And that's when Britain was on the winning side of World War II in the year 1945. But its wealth, prestige, authority, Everything had been severely reduced. It was not so powerful anymore in the
world. Why?
Because it cost a lot of money, a lot of people died, right?
Yeah.
So Britain was not so powerful anymore after World War II. Would you all remember World War II? It's interesting, right, Ara?
Yeah, but how do all the countries fought for freedom?
No, all the countries did not fight for freedom. This, we are talking about World War II. They are fighting with each other.
How did everybody got free? All the countries are free now.
There are different stories of different countries, right? Like we read about Singapore's freedom, independence from Malaysia. That's a different story. India's independence, it's a different story. So every country, whoever was not free earlier, they have their own independence story. It's not the same for every country.
Yeah?
It's a bit confusing, no?
Yeah.
But you will just try to remember few things today, okay? So after Britishers were weak, after the World War II, they decided to leave India peacefully. But, you know, our 15th August also is a tragic day for India, because that's when it got divided into India and Pakistan. So India's freedom came at the cost of partition. Yeah. First it was all India. And then it became partitioned into India and Pakistan, two countries. It got divided.
Why? But how?
Britishers, they played a trick. They said that you guys cannot live with each other peacefully, so you better live in two countries. That's another story.
And how did it make... Okay.
That's another full story, which we can discuss tonight, okay?
Yeah.
How do we celebrate 15th August in India? Do you know? Let's find out. Now, this is something fun. See, Ara, kids, they take a pledge. Like, you also take pledge in Singapore, right? So they take pledge in India that they will always respect their nation. They sing patriotic songs like Vande Mataram. I'll play Vande Mataram for you today, okay? And they hoist the Indian flag, this one. And they distribute sweets. And all the kids, they carry the Indian flag with them. Like during Singapore National Day, they carry the Singapore flag, right? Kids play a lot of game holding the flag. They ride their bicycle around the neighborhood and they put the flag on the bicycle. They perform a lot of dancing and singing. Some more interesting facts about Indian Independence Day over here. Hey, but are you all ready for the surprise? Our surprise is also coming really quickly. Okay? So, some fun fact about Indian Independence Day. India is not the only country that celebrates independence on the 15th of August. There are some other countries also. Which countries are those, Ara?
Bahrain. North Korea.
Now, North Korea.
Congo.
South Korea. And this one is a very difficult name for me. Liechtenstein. Okay. So these are some of the other countries also which celebrate
Indian Independence Day.
No, which also celebrate their Independence Day on the 15th of August. Okay.
But why?
They also got independence on 15th of August. Not in the same year, not in 1947, but in a different year.
But they were also But they were also attacking some countries, some of them, right?
That's their story. We are not talking about their stories today. We are just talking about a fun fact that India is not the only country which is celebrating Independence Day on 15th of August. There are other countries as well, okay?
Huh.
All right. Let's move ahead. Whose flag is this? Which countries do you know? I think it's North Korea or South Korea. I'm not sure.
Yeah, it's South Korea.
You know what is the national anthem of India? Does anybody know?
What?
Do you know the national anthem of India?
No, you taught me.
I never taught you.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's Jana Gana Mana.
Jana Gana Mana?
Jana Gana Mana.
Wait, I think so. My school teachers
taught you.
Yeah.
I think it's. I never taught Jana Gana Mana to Arav. So today is a good day to teach you Jana Gana Mana. Kids, tell me, do you all know Jana Gana Mana?
My school teachers taught me, but now forgotten.
Scatterbrain. Yeah. Scatterbrain. Do you, any of you, do you know Jana Gana Mana? Can you sing for us?
Huh?
I'm asking our friends, can they sing for us Jana Gana Mana? But we can't hear them, right?
Jana Gana
Too bad. I think Nirav knows Jana Gana Mana. This is the national anthem of India. I'll just say two lines.
Wait, they can type a long message.
Yeah, Arav, like how you sing, that one, no? Majula Singapura?
Yeah.
Like that? This is the national anthem of India. Jana Gana Mana Adhinayak Jay Hai. I'll play for you today, okay? Yeah. Right? And this was composed by Rabindranath Tagore. And we did not have a national anthem in 1947 when we got independence. We got it in the year 1953, years after, okay?
What? Okay.
And this is Chacha Nehru. He was the first Prime Minister of India.
Why do you call him Chacha?
He's fondly called as Chacha Nehru. His name is Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru. Mahatma Gandhi, jo the, he was known as Bapu, the father of the nation. Yeah. And Jawaharlal Nehru, he was known as the?
Chachu.
Oh, Chachu.
Wait. Yeah.
Was he?
Chacha Nehru. Oh. Yeah. Now, we are meeting Sardar Vallabh Bhai Patel. You know, Arav, even after we got independence, there were different kingdoms in India. They were not united. Mm-hmm. Sardar Vallabh Bhai Patel, he is known as the Iron Man of India. Yeah, did you know?
No.
So, Sardar Vallabh Bhai Patel. Mm-hmm. And there's a big statue of Sardar Vallabh Bhai Patel in Gujarat. I think it's the world's tallest statue. Mm-hmm. Later, I'll show you the
picture. I thought Paris is Paris taller.
Which one? Paris?
Yeah.
Oh, you mean the statue of... No. What's that called?
The Tower of Paris.
Yeah. But what's that called? Eiffel Tower.
Yeah.
No, I think in terms of the statue, now Sardar Vallabh Bhai statue in Gujarat is the tallest statue in the world. That's what I think. In but we will cross check. I think so. So, he was the Iron Man of India and he united all the different kingdoms. Using different smart strategies. Mm-hmm. Will you remember who's the Iron Man of India? Sardar Vallabh Bhai Patel. And this is India. You know, Arab, that time there were 565 kingdoms which Sardar Vallabh Bhai Patel united. How many?
565.
Just think about it. Sometimes in playground when you are five or six friends, it's so difficult to come to a common decision. Isn't it? Like which game to play? Even 5-6 people cannot decide. Yeah? It's difficult to unite them.
I have to say something.
Yeah?
It's about India but another fight. May I tell you?
Yeah?
The fight about Pakistan and India because of Kashmir, right? Remember the fight of Pakistan and India because of Kashmir?
Because
Pakistan wanted Kashmir, he fought against India. And then Indians finally fought for their freedom and then all the money was going somewhere else.
Arab, that's a very controversial topic, okay? So let's focus on Indian independence, okay?
Yeah.
Okay. So amongst the 565 kingdoms, Jammu, Kashmir, Hyderabad, Mysore, they were amongst the biggest. See over here, the head of India. This is Jammu and Kashmir.
India is not that big.
India is very big.
This looks like China.
No. We are talking about the different kingdoms in India.
Oh.
This is a map of India. Goa was a Portuguese colony even after independence. And it became a part of India after 4 years after independence. In the year 1961. Not 4 years. It's 1961. We got independence in 1947. 14 years after independence, Goa became a part of India.
What is Goa?
Goa is one of the cities in India.
Okay.
Yeah. Like Raipur is one of the cities that you go.
Yeah.
So just trying to explain to you that India was not like full map was there as soon as it got independence. There were many different kingdoms. And who united them all? Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel.
Known as the Iron Man of Singapore.
Known as the Iron Man of India. And there were some... And there were some kingdoms who became a part of India, like properly, much later. Yeah? Just learning a little bit. I know it will be very difficult for you to remember all this, but it's good to know your history. It's good to know it was not easy to unite everybody together and to respect it, that yes, we are united, and to value it and to respect everybody. Yeah? Yeah?
Yeah.
Make sense?
Yeah.
Awesome. Now I also wanted to ask you, but first let me share with you. This is called the Red Fort in New Delhi. And this is where, like every Independence Day, Indian government, they will hoist the red, the Indian flag in the Red Fort. Can you see a flag?
Yeah. Wasn't it destroyed by acid rain?
Red Fort was destroyed by acid rain?
Yeah.
I'm not sure. Alex, Dad, can you please check that out? Arav has some pieces of information which I'm not aware about. Arab, during the partition between India and Pakistan, it was not easy. A lot of people lost their lives.
Yeah.
And this led to the largest human migration in history. You have heard about bird migration.
Yeah.
They go to the south when it's winter season,
yeah,
isn't it?
Yeah.
But this, the partition, it led to the largest human migration in the history. A lot of people from India went to Pakistan. A lot of people from Pakistan went to India. The trains were full and a lot of violence happened. A lot of people got killed. So it was not easy. Our freedom came at a very big cost. A lot of lives were lost. Yeah? So is it good to know about India's independence?
Yeah.
Yeah? Can we salute all the heroes who lost their lives for India's independence?
Yeah.
A big salute to them?
Yeah.
Right hand.
Yeah, right hand. Oh. Right hand. Can we salute? Yeah. Are you feeling proud?
Yeah.
Of all of them?
There are more fun facts.
There are more fun facts. But I think I want to stop here and I want to include you all. Hey, we have some information. Tallest building is Burj Khalifa. Tallest statue is Statue of Unity. Yes, Statue of Unity is the statue of Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel. Thanks, Ketan, for sharing this with us.
Tallest building is what building?
No, Kian shared it with us. Thank you, Kian, for sharing.
That's taller than Paris.
That's what they're saying. Burj Khalifa is the tallest building. So, Kian searched for us. So, guys, I wanted to ask you all children today, you know what our ancestors, like what all the leaders did for us to give us independence, right? They sacrificed their lives and they made a lot of sacrifice. What can you do now that you have independence? How can you contribute? Can you think of some ways to contribute to your country or where you live? Some way. You can contribute in small ways. Can you think of something that you can do for your country, for your people, for your community? How you can help out? Anything.
I like to help with animals, so I did make a cake and leave it outside my house on the ground and put some water also.
That's a good idea. You can leave some water for the animals. So you can put some water in small bowls and keep it outside your house or maybe on the corner of the road. So whenever the animals are thirsty, they can drink some water. That's a good idea. What else can you do?
Animals eat food.
What can you do? I think one simple way is, you all can study well, yeah? You can focus on your studies and you all can become really intelligent. So when you grow up, you can make some inventions if you are scientists, do some great, like you can make, create some nice inventions if you all are like engineers, save lives as doctors, create wealth as businessmen, yeah? Yes, Arav.
Did you know, have you mentioned, I wanted to be a scientist all my life.
Yeah, but for to be a scientist, you have to do a lot of hard work, no? There has to be a lot of dedication. Studying every day without mama having to tell you. Learning new things, doing some experiments every time. By yourself. Nobody has to remind you that, yeah? Can you all tell me any other ways how you can contribute back as children? By keeping your room clean. By not littering the streets. By throwing the litter in the dustbin. Can you do that? It's easy to do, right?
Yeah.
What else can you do as kids? Can you think of something else?
Raise up some independence flag.
That you can do. What else can you do? Can you do small acts of kindness for elder people? Like you can hold the door for people when they are going, right?
Yeah.
You can hold the door for elder people and for kids younger than you. If you're sitting on a bus, and it's fully crowded, you can get up and give that seat to some elderly or some kids if needed. Can you do all those things?
Yeah.
So what are the other small things that you can do as kids? Give me one thing, at least one thing. Think about it. See, I gave you some things. You can do your homework. You can be kind to people. Hold the door for them. Yeah, you can do small acts of kindness.
You should hold the door.
That you can do by helping needy people. That's right. You can share food.
Yeah.
If you see that somebody is not very educated, some kids you see on the street, you can educate them. You can share some books with them. You can share your clothes with them.
Yeah.
And I really love this one, by planting more trees.
That's
planting more trees will save a lot of lives, animal lives and human lives. That's very good, Preeti.
Oh, this is
by not wasting water. That's right.
By always
remembering to switch off the tap. Even when you are one, can I finish this?
Yeah.
When you're brushing your teeth, a lot of us, we just open the tap and keep the water running, right? Instead of that, we can start using a glass.
Yeah.
We will save lots of water. Yes, Arav.
Yeah. We can also do this, for example, to help India and all the people.
Yeah, whichever country you live, you know, every country has its own independence story, its own struggles and journey.
We could try stopping most of the cars in India and instead telling them to make more buses instead of cars.
That's a great idea. But Arav, listen, instead of changing everybody else, what can you do?
I'll try.
Don't think about what you can make others do. Think about how you can contribute.
I'll try making more buses by myself.
Can you do it now?
No.
What can you do now? Is my question to you. There are many things that you can do now. See how the friend suggested they can stop wasting water. They can stop wasting electricity. They can plant more trees. They can donate things like old toys. Yeah? Not wasting food. Every day, we have to agree this. Every day you never finish your tiffin, which I pack for you in the school, and we have to throw the food, isn't it?
Yeah.
And I'm sure other kids also do the same. Yeah? We throw a lot of food every day. We can save it. So these are some of great ideas by you. Thank you so much for sharing this with us. And let's keep thinking. How can we contribute now? Okay? As kids, what can we do? Good, no?
Yeah.
And then we all can come up with great ideas and we can share with each other. I got very excited and emotional about it and it all became very preachy. So now is the time for celebration. Arav, you close your eyes. Are you all ready for the surprise? Close your eyes and the surprise will be here. So this one Arav doesn't know.
And there's a cake.
Now he saw. I baked it at home and I decorated it. And I hope you can see it. I have to adjust the camera.
I wish
we could cut it together. Happy Independence Day to all of you guys.
But the pastry.
A very, very happy Independence Day to you. Shall we all cut it together? On the count of 1, 2, 3. Happy birthday, India. Happy birthday, India. Happy birthday, dear India. Happy birthday, India. I wish I could share the cake with all of you. Thanks for joining us for this special story. Please make some cake and have it home. I'm feeling very bad that I cannot share it with you all. But thanks for joining me today. We'll see you tomorrow with another interesting story.
By the way, I should admit, it's quite delicious.
Bye, guys.
Bye. See ya.
See you. Bye-bye.